Look what it says in Psalm 3. And probably some of you are facing troubles. I have news for you. Prayer can cancel trouble. Lord, how are they increased that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Many there be which say of my soul, there's no help for him in God. Here is David saying, I'm in trouble. But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the lifter of mine head. I cried unto the Lord. Here's prayer. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill. The next thing we see is peace. He says, I laid me down and slept. I awaked, for the Lord sustained me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people that have set themselves against me. Why? Because I prayed, things have changed. When you pray, everything changes. And the word gives birth to prayer. Say it with me. The word will birth prayer. And now once you begin to pray, amazing things begin to happen. Let me read some of them to you. Psalm 34, for example, says, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. You want all your fears gone? Pray. This poor man cried and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. You want all your troubles gone? Pray. Look what it says here. The young lions, this is verse 10, Psalm 34. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. In other words, if you seek God, you'll never lack. You'll never need a thing if you seek God. But only the word will birth prayer. Now, the second you begin to pray, something marvelous begins to happen. The power of God begins to fall on your life. I, in prayer, discovered the power of God. I didn't even know the power of God existed until I began to pray. Now listen to this magnificent verse. Psalm 55:22, cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. He shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. Psalm 56, verse 3. What time I'm afraid, I'll trust in thee. Verse 9, Psalm 56. When I cry unto thee, then shall mine enemies turn back. How many here want the enemies to turn away from you? Say yes. Yes. So what do you do? Pray. And the devil will fight you. When you pray, everything goes wrong. Everything happens. He'll distract you because he knows the power of prayer. Remember, a Christian on his knees has more power in his little finger than all the power in hell. So young people, it's time to quit playing games. It's time to quit watching junk. It's time to quit giving the devil space and get on your knees till the Holy Ghost shows up. Luke 3:21 says, when Jesus was praying in Jordan, he was being baptized and praying. He was in prayer. Luke 3:21, now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and praying, the heavens opened and the Holy Ghost descended on him as a dove. What was he doing? Prayer will produce power. You don't get it any other way. Prayer brings power. Say it. In Acts 1 verse 8, Jesus said to his disciples, ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come on you. But then in verse 14, it says, they continued in prayer. They got together. When Jesus gave a promise, He said, ye shall receive power between the promise of power and the coming of power, there is prayer. Hear this. Acts 1:8, ye shall receive power. Acts 2:1, the power came. Acts 1:14, they were praying. Now God has given you the promise. The reason you don't have it is because you haven't prayed to get it. Say after me. Promise.
Promise.
Prayer.
Prayer.
Power.
Power.
Say it again. Now, you have the promise. Everybody has the promise. The promise was given 2,000 years ago. What must you do to get it? What must you do to get it? What are you waiting for? Pray till you receive it. What did they do? Prayed. Acts 1:14, they prayed. In fact, they prayed for 10 days, not just 10 minutes. And 10 days later, the power shook the room. And the fire appeared. And they began to speak in tongues and preach the gospel and heal the sick. Now, I have news for you. The power they received was just the beginning. The power promised to you is greater, 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 greater. In fact, the scripture says, they began with power, and then the power changed to great power. In Acts 4, it says, with great power, they gave witness. How many of you young people truly want the power of God? Now stand up, all of you, and say out loud, the word will birth prayer, and prayer will birth power.
Power!
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 Power! It's that simple. Now that's what you have to do. That's what I had to do as a young person. When you give yourself to the word, you must dismiss yourself from the world. If the word is in you, the world will leave you. But if the world is in you, the word will leave you. It's a price. It's your choice. If you seek God, you'll find Him. You find His power. And He'll take a nothing and use it for His glory. Now, young people, here's what I want you to do. For the next 5 minutes, I want you to pray with intensity. I want nobody leaving this stadium. I know it's late, but you're here Monday night, hungry for God, and I promise you, you will not leave the same in Jesus' name.
You are mighty.
There is no God like you.
There is no God.
Jesus.
And we worship you.
Keep
keep praying, young people. The Lord's answering you. Keep praying. The Lord's listening to you.